20th century's first half saw the emergence of great leaders in regions where people were oppressed by the European imperial powers. Second World War had weakened the imperial powers all around the world and created an opportunity for these leaders to break the shackles of slavery and declare their independence. And many of them got succeeded. Then these political leaders become great leaders or founding fathers for their people. This first generation of leaders was mostly humble and contented at whatever they had achieved, and they tried to work wholeheartedly to develop and strengthen their nations. After them came the second generation of leaders who inherited state or political legacy without any struggle. We can call them the children of the great leaders. This generation was the most ambitious, greedy, and ruthless generation, and they created an era which is called the Decade of Turmoil. They not only opposed the ideology of their predecessors, but also set trends in politics which made the life of their people miserable. The list of these children is very long, but we will discuss only one child in an episode, selected from a single region. Our first region is South Asia. The child we are going to discuss from our list of the children of great leaders is Muhammad Daud Khan. He was very good at making enemies. Although he was the Prime Minister of Afghanistan for 10 years, but he spent most of his time thinking about the Pashtuns of neighboring country instead of thinking about the development of the Pashtuns of his own country. Non-Pashtuns collectively formed majority in Afghanistan, but he never bothered to think about them. This way of his thinking made both his neighbor and non-Pashtuns angry. After 10 years of prime ministership, he felt that he needed more power, but his cousin king refused to give him more power simply because he couldn't give. But Daud did not believe him. So he overthrew the king and himself became the president. This made the king, royal family, and those who were loyal to the king very angry. Daud then tried to westernize the country, but this made Islamists angry. He then tried to reduce the increasing power of the Soviet-backed Communist Party, but it made both the Soviet and Communist Party angry. They then decided to overthrow him and launched a military coup. Daud resisted and got killed along with all of his family members. He left behind many groups of angry people that never agreed with one another, but they collectively destroyed Afghanistan.